The bamboo tree is one of the rare plants that have over 1,000 uses. This is especially evident in the bamboo usage in the Asian countries. The bamboo tree is used for various purposes ranging from art, building houses, bridges, and restaurants. In Vietnam, a community has built a 320-meter bridge that interconnects their villages. Bamboo is easy to use, and testimony to this is in Thailand, where 500 natives used 6 days to build a 1,476 feet long bamboo bridge. The construction industry in Kenya needs to borrow a leaf from the Asian countries and use bamboo in some construction to help bring the prices of construction to manageable levels. Bamboo is one of the fastest growing plants in the world, reaching maturity at 3 to 6 years, depending on the species. Its massive fibrous rooting system and dense vegetative cover make it an excellent species for soil conservation and regulation of water flow.
Bamboo has been identified as a species that is very good for conservation. Bamboo is known to have over 1,000 uses. From the very basics of construction to making furniture to flooring, it provides very good material for fuel wood.
It also provides a vegetative cover since it has an ability to readily regenerate and coppice, hence making it survive for a long time. Bamboo contribution as a carbon sink plays an important role in mitigating climate change and global warming, which is a challenge caused by increase in carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Growing bamboo near water bodies helps in purifying the water by removing heavy metals and nutrients, hence its conservational role.
Bamboo has been found to be a water purifier, and therefore when you grow it in wetlands, when you grow it in on riverbanks, it purifies the water. You also find that bamboo out there in the world is very good food for the wildlife. And so you can see our bamboo can be used for balancing our ecosystem so that our animals out there have food. At the same time, it is conserving our soils. At the same time, it is conserving our waters.
Bamboo shoots provide food for wild animals and humans. They are said to contain a wide variety of nutrients, including amino acids, vitamins, carbohydrate, minerals, and fiber, which is well known for its ability to reduce cholesterol in human body. Bamboo is a good fencing material and also an excellent source of energy. With its fast growth and quick biomass gain, it provides a better alternative, considering that over 80% of Kenyans use wood as their main source of energy.
Currently, our forest cover stands at 6.9, the country forest cover. In the Lake Victoria Basin, where we are undertaking our project, we have the forest cover of 1.5 from the statistics we got from the Kenya Forest Service, and also tree cover of 0.9% through our Lake Victoria Environment Management Project 2 baseline survey. So we saw it was good that we trained farmers to take in the issue of the bamboo growing. This one, we are so encouraging bamboo growing because the importance of bamboo in our ecosystem.
There are two types of bamboo that are grown in Kenya, giant and non-giant. All these species can grow well in different parts of the country. Bamboo growing is being encouraged within the Lake Victoria Basin and the country at large.
Awamu ya pili ya mradi wa LFM2 tuliweza kufahamisha wakulima umuhimu wa bamboo, na kama jinsi mmeona tuna miche za miti na miche za bamboo. Na miche za bamboo tumekuza miche za bamboo chache kidogo kwa sababu ilikuwa ni mwanzo. Baada sisi kutoka kupatiwa mafunzo na LFM2, tulikuja tukaanza kuweka miche ambazo tulipata mbegu kidogo, tukakuja tukaweka na tumefaulu.
Lake Victoria Environment Management Project Phase 2, LVEMP2, has realized the need to grow bamboo, which will contribute to the environment conservation and livelihoods improvement in Lake Victoria Basin, thus supporting the bamboo growing in the area.
As LVEMP2, we have an objective of conserving our wetlands. So bamboo comes in handy of conserving our wetlands, come generating activity, and two, it will also act as is a very good plant in conservation of the wetland because it conserves water, so it will go a long way in conserving the environment. Secondly, also in these wetlands, you know, the problem we have been having with our wetlands in this country is encroachment. So bamboo will go a long way in creating a buffer zone. As much as people are growing bamboo for income, they're also creating a buffer zone for these for the wetland.
The project objectives are to improve environmental conservation, livelihood improvement by induction of income-generating activities through community-driven sub-development projects, restoration and protection of water catchment areas, wetlands, riverbanks, bare hills, and degraded forest areas.
This project yetu tumeanza na LVEMP, tumejenga tanki ya maji, tumepanua nasari yetu ya miti, na pia tumefundishwa maneno ya bamboo. Tunajivunia LVEMP kwa kuwa walitupeleka sehemu ya Aero, tukajifunza, paka tumekuja tuta miti hiyo bamboo zaidi ya 20,000.
The project embarked on environment conservation and livelihood improvement through sensitization and training of the CDD groups that undertook forestry sub-projects. 94 groups from wetland riparian communities were trained on bamboo propagation, management and utilization.
I just come to Londiani for bamboo training. First of all, I'm going to teach my fellow members of the group on the importance of this bamboo, how to propagate, the uses of it. I see this bamboo is very important because inside the farm, you are going to intercrop. So you cannot waste your land. I find this training very important. I thank the LVEMP.
After the training, more communities have started bamboo farming in Lake Victoria Basin, and there are high expectations that bamboo production and use will increase in the coming years. Bamboo presents an opportunity that should be exploited as it can support industries and contribute to our economy, as is the case in the Asian countries.
So bamboo will go a long way in creating a buffer zone whereby it will have that zone between the wetland and the community members we are encroaching. So as much as we are planting bamboo, we are encouraging the planting of bamboo. We all know that we are using it also in the conservation of the wetland. Bamboo has some fibrous roots that are able to hold the water together so that the discharge to the lake we have clean water, we have adequate water that flows to the lake. So we'll be getting a continuous supply, a continuous flow of water to the lake. And that's one of the objectives of the Lake Victoria Environment Management Project, to sustain and to ensure that we reduce the stress in the Lake Victoria.